In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create an incoming geometry shader to create this gradient material. I'll hide this mesh for now. Let's create a plane. I'll add two array modifiers like this. Let's add the solidify modifier. Let's add a curve point. If you don't see the curve point, please activate an extra objects add-on. I'll show you why I always ask everyone to press the 3D button after creating a curve point. If the curve type is set to 2D, then we can't extrude the point on the Z axis. Once the curve type is set to 3D, then we can type E to extrude up or down freely. Let's extrude the point like this. In edit mode, type A, V, and A to smooth the curve. That's A to select all, V to set the handle type, and A to smooth it. Let's select the plane mesh and add the curve modifier. We can freely modify the overall shape of the mesh by scaling the curve like this. Let's apply the material. I'll go back to the original mesh and show you the full nodes. The incoming geometry node can be used for any nodes that are equipped with a blue connector. I have tried connecting it to other types, but they didn't work well. The idea is to use the incoming node to change the color of the mesh gradually as the mesh rotates. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.